Chapter 16. That true solace is to be sought in God alone. Whatsoever I am able to desire or to think of for my solace, I look for it not here, but hereafter. For if I alone had all the solaces of this world, and were able to enjoy all its delights, it is certain that they could not endure long. Wherefore, O my soul, thou canst be fully comforted and perfectly refreshed, only in God, the comforter of the poor, and the lifter up of the humble. Wait but a little while, my soul, wait for the divine promise, and thou shalt have abundance of all good things in heaven. If thou longest too inordinately for the things which are now, thou shalt lose those which are eternal and heavenly. Let temporal things be in the use, eternal things in the desire. Thou canst not be satisfied with any temporal good, for thou wast not created for the enjoyment of these. Although thou hadst all the good things which ever were created, yet couldst not thou be happy and blessed. All thy blessedness and thy felicity lieth in God, who created all things. Not such felicity as seemeth good to the foolish lover of the world, but such as Christ's good and faithful servants wait for, and as the spiritual and pure in heart sometimes taste, whose conservation is in heaven. Philippians 3, verse 20. All human solace is empty and short-lived. Blessed and true is that solace which is felt inwardly, springing from the truth. The godly man everywhere beareth about with him his own comforter, Jesus, and saith unto him, Be with me, Lord Jesus, always and everywhere. Let it be my comfort to be able to give up cheerfully all human comfort. And if thy consolation fail me, let thy will and righteous approval be always with me for the highest comfort. For thou wilt not always be chiding, neither keepest thou thine anger for ever. Psalm 102, verse 9.